Anyone?
Yes, Dinesh, we are able to see.
Okay, so this is the first day session, so it's like your doubts or clarification, and then we can go for the session directly. Okay, it's not a demo, so we will start directly and we will go to the continuous session. Few of them is reserved your seats, so rest of them you just ask your questions. If you have any doubt, we can discuss that first. Okay, so everyone know the agenda, right? Everyone will see the syllabus.
Yeah.
Any question in that? No question. So timing, you know very well. Yeah, please.
Yeah, Dinesh, so just wanted to know, I mean, so here we'll be doing exactly like how, you know, the big data, you know, developers supposed to do. So let's say, you know, we'll be doing all the developments in the local. Then after that, we'll push the codes in the cloud. I mean, the process how it do, right?
No, actual here, there is a two process. One is for the practice. That is, we will be providing a standalone VM. As a practice cluster, you can do that.
Okay.
And later on, cloud-based, we will be going to see how that reality, how they are deploying that code, how they will be executing that functionality with cloud. So that are all reality that we will be going to discuss. Why we are giving the practice VM, if suppose you complete the course and the new any ecosystem will be released in future. Let's consider right now Hadoop 3 is going on. Hadoop 4 is going to be released. So at the time you cannot buy the cloud again and you cannot do that because it's charging. When I'm going to purchase them, you have to pay for them, then only you can use it.
Okay.
So that we're just giving you a practice VM, which will be a latest, we will be upgrade and we'll give you all the time. You have studied right now. In future, you want to practice again.
Mm-hmm.
Some other new concept here that will be reached into the big data platform, you want to learn it. You don't want to purchase anything directly, you just go and download that practice VM and you can utilize it. That's it. For because the cloud is understanding purpose is needed, but you cannot pay for every time.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that's the reason we will give you all the hands-on that will be easy for your practice VM. So suppose you are going to pay and buy that VM, you can practice 2 months. After 3rd month, you will be getting a job or you'll be diverted to somewhere. Again, you'll come back to big data. So it's continuously you want to pay and you'll be getting frustrated. So practice VM, whenever you have doubt, you can open it and you can practice.
Okay, so no need to install anything in the local machine. I mean, just a VM.
Except just only the VM is enough. We will include all the softwares properly and we'll be common. It will be combined with other ecosystems. Okay?
Okay.
But we should see that in cloud also, I'm sure. With programmatic.
Okay. So,
okay.
So in normal scenarios, I mean, like, let's say, you know, as we wanted to, you know, get into the big data technologies. So normal scenarios, like how it works. So basically, so there won't be any VM, right? So they will be like installing the local machine and then they do the development and then they deploy the code in the like cloud. That is what has happened.
Yeah, the same, whatever you're practicing the VM, right? They will be using as a edge node. That's it. Via edge node, they are going to connect to the cloud and they will be deploy their code. The same we are trying here, but the practice VM, once we have developed the code and practiced properly, we just do some changes with respect to cloud because some libraries will be modified for the cloud environment for because we just plan to go with Azure and AWS both, right?
Mm-hmm.
So AWS library is different, Azure library is different. And with respect to some configuration, we have to modify. Everything we are going to do that and we are going to upload into the cloud and we can execute it. Then you can see how the actual, the reality of big data platform, how it is working. You can see in visualize there.
Okay. And like, so it will be like how many, what is the percentage of theoretical class and, you know, the practical sessions, or you'll be like giving us the like some kind of scenario based questions which we practice. So how it's going to work that time?
Actually, our session is completely 20% theory and 80% practical. That practical relevance to interview questions.
Okay,
because what kind of question they will be asked in that interview, based on that we will be sort out that all the content. We will be going to discuss that one by one. During the time, I will tell you what kind of question they will ask you and what is the answer. So almost 80% you will get confident while you go for the interview. Few 20% you need some in-depth, that once you learn about the cloud practice, you will get it much. I'm sure that. Okay. And cloud practice, we will not go only for the service. Okay, we will not be create the service, tell it the service, not like that. Programmatic only we are going to approach it. Because everyone can create the services, it's not a big deal. They will give you. But you have to do the practice, surely. Am I right?
And it will be a recorded session, right? Like you will be uploading it in YouTube, or you have any separate channel for that?
I have a separate drive and I can load all the details and will give you.
So every day, I mean, so whatever be the class happen, like, you know, every day you'll be loading those videos.
Yeah, exactly. The class end after 24 hours, within 24 hours, you will upload that on the day recording. You can practice it with the notes.
Okay.
Notes we will give you. And videos we can give you, and what is that? Some class notes, right? Okay, that
yeah.
is I mentioned right below. Some slides we have used for the slides references, and some snippets. Something we will draw and write some pictures. Later, whatever we will be discussing, we will go some drawings. So that all will be sad, and some assignments.
Okay. So how do, I mean, let's say today we have, you know, you have completed the lecture, then after that, you know, we do have the doubts and those things. So are we going to have a separate doubt session, or in the next class in the morning, like, we'll start with the doubt session?
No, this is a timing. So class will be 4 days classes. Okay, so this is normal classes. 1 day. Doubt clarification.
Okay.
If suppose you don't have any doubt, then we can go forward. Because this is a, we have received from the previous batch as a feedback, so that we just plan to go like this. Because whatever we will be doing the practice, you have to do it from your end.
Yeah.
That you may be stuck something, right? So we will give you 4 days of classes, and 1 day you can do some practice on whatever you're facing the issue. We'll be focused on that. Everyone, okay, because if you have any trouble, you can ask anything.
So it will be this doubt session, the doubt day will be the mid of the week, or it will be the end of the week?
It's a, at the end of the week we will be, whatever will be the 4 days we will learn, right? There you are going to do some hands, so you will get some doubts, you maybe have some struggles that we are going to discuss there.
Okay
Guru. Go ahead.
Yeah. Hi, Dinesh. Very good morning.
Yeah. Good morning.
I have small doubt about the support. So how we are going to get the support? Like if you had any query from some particular part, so we just need to move on, right? So how we are getting support?
Don't worry. Whatever you have issues, we will create a private batch for you. You can raise it there itself. Okay. So there any doubts, you can raise it, or you need a support, you can raise that. We will be connect you with one-to-one. We have separate trainer also there. They will connect you and we'll sort out your issues. Don't worry.
Yeah, and could you please let us know the syllabus just briefly?
Yeah, syllabus you know, right?
Yes, I know. But just give some introduction about the syllabus.
Okay, no problem. Just a minute.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so this is the latest syllabus. Just open it. Actually, there is a mistake. It was mentioned as a Tamil, but Tamil batch has already started. It's English only. Yeah, okay. You can be able to see my screen, right? Probably. So this is our agenda, this is the policy. So it's not a fast track, maximum 30% of theory will go. 70% is completely hands-on, and 1 day is a doubt session. That's just before I say. Suppose you're not satisfied while going this session, we will refund your 100% amount without any queries. Okay? You don't bother about it. And it should be in interactive and concept basis, and versions will be in Hadoop, the practice VM, whatever we will give you, right? That will be a latest version only we will give you. The reason behind, once you learn your studies and you go for the real time, at the time, the version will be upgraded again. So you don't want to learn this old. So whatever is the new environment, you can practice it. And while you go for the interview or you will go for the original Big Data platform, they may be upgrade their version also. So this will definitely will help you, so that we just plan to go with Hadoop 3x and Spark 3x and private WhatsApp group for even all your queries. Suppose you have any queries in your practice, or you may be stuck somewhere, you can raise the query there itself. We will connect you. If you feel not comfort there, you can text me in private also. Even session is going on. If suppose you have some chilly question, you can mention in the chat window in private. I will help you. And I don't mention your name. Directly, I can read your question and answer it. Because here, the take and non-take, both are coming for the practice. So somebody will not know the basics also. I know that. So if you don't understand, or if you have some doubts on that, you can raise it in private chat for me. I will answer to you without mentioning your name, to be honest. Okay, this should be 100%. You need to understand. That's the reason we will not be taking the first try. Are you clear? Once you understand the concept, we can go forward for the next.
Hi, Dinesh.
Yeah, please go ahead.
I just want to know, so you said 4 days of theory and 1 day for...
Not theory, four classes.
So are you going to cover all this within 4 days and 1 hour per day, right?
It's not like that. So it depends on the content, right? What are the content we have mentioned, we will be covered. If suppose you have a doubt, you mean you'll not be clear in the particular topic, right? Sure. We will be trying different manner. Because it's the content based. Once you understand the concept, then only you can go forward. That's what you cannot assure the timing. Approximate only we just give you, it will go more than that, I'm sure.
Okay. But the classes are on 7:15 to 8:15 every day.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Because exactly 7 o'clock I have met and I just started, and a few of them will be joined 7:05, 7:10.
Sure, got it.
So I just noted the everyone mindset. So I just plan to change 15 minutes more. That's it.
Sure. So approximately 4 to 5 hours of classes and one day left for assignments.
Yeah. 1 day you're going to ask your doubts, and you maybe used my queries, whatever, I will give you the hands-on query, right? While you are doing the practice, you may be stuck somewhere. You just come back to me, you can raise it. It's a open or it's a private, that's not a bother. Okay, we can discuss that point and then we can go forward. If suppose you don't have any question, we can take as a classes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, it's a continuation. Beyond anything. So if suppose you have any particular concept you are not understanding, we will try to explain you in a different way. Right? So that's the reason we will not be going more papers here. Only restricted, and it will be in a correct decent way. Understanding, because you are going to face the interview, you want to answer them. Am I right?
Yeah, makes sense. Thank you.
Yeah, that's the reason. Any other question?
Yeah, hi Dinesh. One more question. By any chance, are you using the real-time scenario or is it just like something normal one?
Yeah, it's a real-time scenario we are going to practice. We will be take some data and we will be practice it. And data is a try data set we are using right now. In real-time, you're going to see everything via cloud. I'm sure it with program. You know, everywhere we are going everything with Python only, PySpark, Python related only. So the same you're going to do that by cloud real-time practice, because it's a programmatic is very important. As a developer perspective, I just informing you. Okay, while you're going to practice it in your cloud, everyone will create the service, they will give the access to you, but you have to do it by program. So those program, how we can create it, how we can achieve it, everything you're going to see it in project flow, in cloud.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Yeah.
Dinesh, so basically, just tell me. I mean, like, you know, normally when we start working, you know, because you know I work in BI, let's say, you know, like if somebody's working in different aspects, so they wouldn't be, you know, sure about, you know, what kind of errors or let's say any kind of enhancements, like anything will come, and we will be covering here as a developer role, right? Not the administrator part.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
So, yeah, please go ahead. Sorry.
So in that case, I mean, let's say, you know, like the person like me, I'm talking about. So let's say, you know, from one domain to, you know, switch completely into the different domain. So at that time, we are not even sure about, you know, what kind of situations come, you know, where we will be facing those kind of issues or something. So are we going to, like, you know, at least, you know, explain about those kind of real-time issues, or it will be a, like, how the session will be, just wanted to understand.
Yeah, exactly. Thus, we are going to focus via real-time practice only. How in real time they are going to approach you, the same we will practice it. And suppose we are going to use it multiple data set, not only for the data set, we will be going to interact with the database also. So how the real time the project is going on, we just doing the same practice here. So if suppose you are going to face some errors, okay? So you can raise it definitely at the end of the session, your colleague will help you because it was happening and few of them is got offer. So they will definitely help you to fix your issues, or we will help you with that things. You don't worry about it. Okay, okay, but you must know something.
Sure. Okay? Yeah, because that the whole purpose of the whole purpose of having this, you know, like having this training is all about, like, you know, I want to switch into the big data technology.
Yeah, exactly. So
that I don't know about the other people. Like probably like most of them have the same mindset of, you know, switching the switching to big data. Fine then, yeah, that's it.
Any other question?
I have one more question, Dinesh. Could you please differentiate the role for the full stack engineer? So I really don't know about it.
Okay, no problem.
I mean, what are the roles and responsibilities?
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
Okay, I don't have proper information. Okay, we can take the first itself. Okay, so here, starting by, you must know that full stack engineer, you must know all the big data environment practice. Okay, you should learn about the AWS cloud or any one of the clouds must be. Okay, and Databricks is the only first Spark related cluster, you must know about it. So that we just give you as a full stack developer. Hadoop is not just a big data platform. It's a kind of tool only. How are you supposed to interact with your cloud environment? That is, you must know that. That is the use of full stack. Not only for the data migration, you have to do the programming, right? So programming concept also you must know. And then you want to do some hands-on the programming, then only you'll get the confidence. And while you migrate the cloud services, how you're going to deploy it properly, that you must know that things, right? So this all will come to the full stack. If suppose you are a big data engineer, before it was a big data engineer, a data engineer, something, there you must know only Hadoop. If suppose know only Hadoop is enough before, but nowadays it's not like that. They must expect you as any one of the cloud, they must expect with some Hadoop related concepts, and Spark is especially running in the backend, as well as some ML related topics. Okay, if suppose you know the ML, that will help you for added advantage. So that you can select AWS or Azure, that's not a big deal. But Azure, AWS is already a lot of opening is there, and the competition also very huge. But Azure is running, is currently is booming and low competition. So if supposed to select Azure, you'll get some better opportunity more to compare with AWS. But real time, AWS have a huge market. That's what I just give you both. As your selection, you can take anyone, or if you are interested, you can take both. Then you get some exposure, how the cloud is working between the AWS and Azure. These things we will give you. Okay.
So Dinesh, in full stack, even the orchestration like Airflow or something like that is included?
Yeah, you know the syllabus, right? This is the syllabus. You can see this one. Hadoop, Hive, Python, Spark, Kafka, HBase, Cassandra, Airflow, and Docker, AWS, Azure, Databricks, Machine Learning. These are all you are going to learn it.
So what is the prerequisite knowledge? Like, what is your expectation that one should already know before doing this course? Because I see there are a lot of topics to cover.
We must know only your system, because already I informed you don't have more. You will come from the non-tech also. You cannot learn everything. I agree with you. So that we will restart the programming from scratch. You can notice the topic number 3 is a Python programming. It's the intermediate level, not from the basic. Whatever you're going to practice via Spark, right? That all we're going to use it in intermediate level. Okay, this is the sequence. First, we will be covered Hadoop and Hive, and then only we are going to start Python Scratch. And intermediate level is over, then we will go for Spark. Then you should have some continuity and you can learn it. As a big data platform, you come, you must know only the SQL concept and programming concept is a basic. Okay, and programming, you can select Scala or Python. This is mostly dominating your role. For future perspective, I just select only Python, and that will help you. And it will be support for all your functionality. But Scala is not like that. It's supposed to go only for data engine as a Spark, then Scala will help you. Apart from you come out from that, then you must know about Java. You want to learn to program. And it's a big deal. It will take more time. But Python is not like that. Once you learn the Python, you can do all the practice with the Spark and Kafka integration or Airflow. So everything will come. Python SDK will give you for cloud also, AWS, Azure, Databricks, everywhere you can plan it. At the end, you are a data engineer now, and in future, you will be become a data scientist role. There also, Python will dominating you. That's the reason I just think and forecasting the future and give you the Python. Okay?
Thanks, Dinesh. And when you say machine learning, does that include just the deployment of models, or are you also
Of how the ML is working, so such things, and Spark also we will be going to learn via machine learning. Spark ML is a kind of core is available. Okay, I will tell you the project flow, that the session flow, how the session flow is. Okay. So first we will be going to discuss Hadoop entirely, and then we will be going to learn about Docker. And then we are going to learn about any cloud practice. Oh, sorry, ML. And then once learn, then you can going to learn about Spark ML. And then we'll be going to learn about clouds, any Azure, AWS, or Databricks. And then we can go forward. This is the way we are going to approach it. Okay, because it's a continuity. Without machine learning concept, we cannot practice via Spark ML. So we cover this basic CMS. One program we are going to execute via Python. Another one project we'll be going to show via Spark machine learning. Because this ML library, how it is supposed to work, that's, you know, then you can clear the interview. It's combinations in nowadays in Hadoop. Mostly EDA processing, they are approaching via Spark nowadays. So you
right, and
that exposure. Yeah.
How long will have the access to the videos?
No, it's, you can use it in lifelong, no issues.
Okay, okay. Thanks, Dinesh. That's all I have.
Yeah.
Hey, Dinesh. One question here. This is Gokul. So the virtual machine, are you going to deploy everything and supply to us? Or is it going to be, I mean, we have to install all
We will help you to installation. But in your system should have at least 8 GB of RAM. This is the only one prerequisite from your end. All the developers are joining here. Your system at least 8 GB of RAM. Okay? Because if suppose we are going to do practice via Docker or that practice via Vagrant or something, there your system goes down. So that we just requesting you, we need at least 8 GB of RAM. If you have, then we can go forward without any problem there. Okay, you just concentrate that point.
Okay.
And daily proper network connection while taking the session. Few of them will be interrupted while connecting, internet issues. So try to avoid that such kind of things.
Yeah, one more question here. I mean, for Python programming, which editor are we gonna use? Like, is there any preferred?
IDE, we are going to practice in Jupyter, PyCharm, and sometimes it's request for Azure is VS Code.
Okay.
This three IDE, we are going to use it. Okay, and shell also sometimes for easy understanding, some shell environment. Okay, so Jupyter and PyCharm mostly using for our Spark development and that code development and all. VS Code for Azure practice. Okay, that will help you more. And shell okay. Also. Suppose we have to create any environment, shell will help. So how the environment created, that all I will help you. Yeah, please.
Yeah. So I mean, Kafka. Are we gonna use Python for Kafka?
Yes. Everything we are go via Python only. Whatever I mentioned, right? All the ecosystem we are going to interact via Python itself. Okay.
So Dinesh, all your code snippets and all the examples will be as per Windows command or Mac?
No, it's not a Windows command. It will be in your VMs, should be in Linux, right? There only we can do the practice.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, so you have to do all the commands via Linux only. The platform should be in Linux because Windows will not be able to help you. So the practice VM, that's what we just give you, it should be in Linux. Okay, because you can use it very roughly. You don't want to fear anything. Suppose it's crashed, you can delete it and you can create a new VM for your practice. Okay, how long you are doing the hands-on, that will help you more. That's it.
You will be also helping with the Linux commands if I don't know,
yes,
Linux.
Yes, don't worry. Before starting that, we will be go with Linux. At the starting of Hadoop commands practice itself, we will be going to see something about Linux commands. Because Hadoop commands is correlated with your Linux commands. So we'll be going to see that also.
Got it. Thanks.
Yeah.
Hi, Dinesh.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah. I see that in the course there is no data visualization tool covered. So any chance of that?
As a data engineer, you will not be doing that visualization, so that I will not be into that. But in project, I will try to show you something with some quick site, something is available. I will try to show you that. Because visualization is like a plug and play. So that we will not be include that point. But okay. I will consider. In future, if it is possible, we can try to include that also.
Sure, sure. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Because the front-end developers are different and back-end developers are different. As a data engineer, you will be a back-end developer. So from that thought process, we have included the Docker.
Okay. Got it. Thanks.
Yeah. Also, in new technology, anything else will be released in the future. Suppose we will be included in our batch new developers. You again, you don't want to pay the entire thing. Whatever you have paid, the rest of the amount you can pay it. I'm just informing everyone. Okay, as a student, you join, you learn everything. In future, we plan to include Snowflake also in Big Data platform. So at the time, you know the notice, right? You'll get some notification. If you're interested in learn in that kind of new technology, you can pay that one only at the time, and then you can go forward. That's it. Okay, it's open information, everyone. Got it? Because the technology will not be assured. This is the only one thing. It must happen so that this informing you before itself. So anything is being deprecated and new technology will come in Big Data platform. There you must learn again from the scratch. It's not required, right? Already you know these things. Only the certain thing you know, that's enough. Will you help us in what all points should be included in the resume? Yeah, sure. After the end of the session, interview tips and tricks, we will discuss there. I will tell you how we have to prepare the resume. And I will give you some sample resume for the Big Data engineer. You can refer it. It's a name only mask. The actual content will be available. You can refer it and you can develop your things. Okay. And job support, somebody is asking. Job support, we will give you only interview related. References and your colleague will help you. We find out the reference that where the job is opening available. Based on our friend's reference, everything I will share you. Such kind of job reference and support we will give you. Okay? Because don't trust any one of the institution for the job surety. They will join you in as freelancer, some small scale industry. So don't trust any one of them. This should be your learning. You know learning, you can get your job. So if suppose you go for the interview, you cannot answer them, you can raise the question to us. We will help you to sort out that. Okay. 1-2 interview, you will be failed, and 3rd or 4th interview, you will be succeeded. This will happen. This is happening actually. So whenever you go for the interview, you stuck somewhere, you can raise the question to us. We will try to sort out that. Definitely we will help you. What kind of question they have asked and what perspective they asked, everything will be monitored and we'll update you.
So Dinesh, in your previous batch, I mean like the person who joined the batch, so what is the percentage of people like, who already get a job or moved into the big data technologies?
Yes. Most of them is more, joined as a fresher for the big data, they have some struggles. Anybody joined here, I think? Anand, are you from previous batch or this batch reserved one? I'm not sure.
No, I'm from this batch.
Okay. Sorry. Okay, nobody's joined from the previous batch because they have private batches, so the group is available. We will be contact for 1-to-1 if suppose they have any problem. Okay.
Dinesh, one question, all these topics will be covered in 60 hours?
No, it's approximate. It crossed more than that also. Last batch is going on almost 80 hours at most, almost it goes on. Because that is a lot of changes we have tried. It's approximate, okay? Because we will not be going strike forward for the entirely. It's a content basis. Sometimes it takes a long time also. This is the July batch, it's completed. Like this, we will create a drive and we will share you. You can do the practice. Almost 41 2-hour sessions this will be. So almost 80 hours it was covered. So it's like this, what are the session we have taken out, we will be update here. With the date, you can refer it.
Okay. What means assignments, what kind of assignments will be there?
Assignments is mostly hackathon part. I forgot to tell you. It's not an assignment. We will not give you the assignment. You will not be doing that. It's a real time. While we are doing the practice, right? At the time itself, I will give you some assignment for a practice purpose. But here it goes as a hackathon. Okay. So once the particular certain session is over, I will divide your team into 2 or 3 based on the count members and will give some work and you will be mingled together. Okay. So you have raised your questions with them. I will give you some private Zoom network to you for the bridge. You can use it. You can do the practice and you'll mingle together to understand the concept. And you want to explain that what you're doing there. Okay, because completely it's a kind of hands-on. I will give you some data set. You have to do it. While you're doing that code development, you will be stuck somewhere, right? Your team will help you. If suppose you cannot sort out that issue, you can come to me. We will discuss. This will go every day 10 minutes at the end of the session or beginning of the session. If suppose you're trying to fake me, then I will start the beginning itself and looking you. You want to share your screen and you want to explain that things. That must be. Okay. Because whatever you will be do the learning, you must do the hands-on also. So that's the reason we will be doing hackathon. This will definitely will help you for your interview cracks. Hackathon will go for batch and streaming. 2 plots will be divided and we'll go on that.
And okay. Here in Spark, we'll be covering the Spark streaming plus batch as well, right? Both the...
Yeah, everything will be covered, including Spark ML also will be covered. Okay, RDD from scratch, core RDD2, data frame, SQL, streaming, ML, Spark streaming, there is a 2 types is available. So both will be, we will be covered. Streaming context and D-streams and streamings.
Okay.
So yeah, because majorly, yeah, please go ahead.
I have 2x in my system, so do I need to upgrade to 3x or should I continue with that?
No, no, it's a kind of VM only, right? You can do the plug and play, that's it.
Yeah, even in Spark. Okay, that we'll do that.
Yeah, in Spark, we will be do the practice with 2x and 3x, both we are going to see it. What are the new feature comes around under to Spark 3x? That is also we are going to discuss. But 2x, we will go with hands-on, definitely. Because in interview, they will ask you more in 2x only nowadays. But few of them, they will know, so they expect you from the exposure of 3x. So we will discuss that also. Okay?
Yes, exactly. Perfect. Thank you, man.
Yeah. And already I have loaded some Udemy videos you can refer for Hadoop 3x, sorry, Spark 3x new features, especially for the performance training rules I just gave you. You can refer it. It's a free one. Week. Okay, anything else? Anything that you expect or missed here, just let me know as a feedback also, no problem.
When are the classes starting?
Yeah, it's going on. From today onwards, it just started. Today and tomorrow will be an open demo session batch because you must know how the session is going on, right? So that confidence expected everyone. I know that. I will give you as an open. After that, whatever you're seeing the speed of the session, that will be a will go on end of the session. We'll not be going hurry-purdy. This is the way we are going to approach it. You need to know that, right? The reality. So that's why I'm giving you.
So Dinesh, the content which I'm going to explain in the in the class, that will be more than enough. Or do you think we should be referring some particular book as well, book or any of that?
We will give you e-library. Okay, we have a huge e-library books. A lot of books are available. We have stored. So this library already I stored. Okay, you can refer it. This is the open choice. Suppose you want to learn some Spark related, this many books is available. So everything, this is already uploaded in our drive. You can refer it and you can practice.
Yeah, I mean, so this will be like huge one. So if you just go to the Spark, you have plenty of plenty of books are there already, right? Of course, I mean, like we as a newbie, we don't know exactly what books to refer. So every book contains a lot of pages, like 500, 600.
So, I agree with that, but the only one problem is a people habit. As of my understand, whatever I suggested, they will not be read. Mm-hmm. They will be come out from their end and they will be read. So I try to load all the ebooks because I also will not be read all the ebooks. Okay, I'm sure I know that about myself. So I'm telling you. So few of them will suggest you this ebook will help you more. You can refer it. I will suggest you something.
Okay.
You can do the practice your own. Because we will not be restrict you. This is the only ebook you want to learn it. So whatever I have, I just load here. You can take it out.
Mm-hmm. So in your training, I mean, like what is the depth of content which we are going to cover?
It's a kind of all the relevant information will be planned. Let's suppose you are going to use the data, how you are going to interact with all kind of file formats you are going to practice, right? ORC, ERC, Pocket. So all the file format we are going to do in hands-on. As well, we are going to interact with cloud platform, something bucket, S3 buckets, and as a block on data lake, something, right? Mm-hmm. So this is the reality. So everything we are going to do it via our approaches. That will be planned. You are go for the job in a big data, you're supposed to handle any data. That should be what relevance of data you are going to handle it. Whether it should be in database relevance or it should be in any file format relevance or any cloud relevance. How you're going to interact with the data and how you'll be doing that approaches. Right? That is a reality. So that the same you are going to approach it. Different file format we are going to approach it. Different DBA we are going to approach it. Different cloud sources we are going to approach it. And between the integration, between the cloud. Azure data, you're going to move into AWS or AWS data, you're going to move into Azure. It will not happen like that. Any one cloud only, the real. I will show you that. Okay.
And all the configuration file changes also, like you'll be like, you know, showing us, right? Spark config, those files.
Yes. That how we can deploy that under the client and cluster integration, how we can schedule that memory values, everything while we are going to see in our cloud, right? Mm-hmm. We are going to use EMR cluster and SD inside there. I can show you how we can provide the value, how it will be reacted. Spark optimization also. Whatever the changes happen, the backend, how it will be modified. That log information, UA references, DAG lines, and while you're going to do the code via at the time, how the data will be fluctuated with multiple stages, everything we are going to see it.
Okay.
Yeah. It's completely reality. How it is going to be, we can show in that virtual, right? I just do the command, how the command will respond the backend. That we are going to see it.
Okay.
Yeah, any other question? Certification exam, we will help you. But what kind of certification? As of my experience, I can help you. So I just give you about myself. Okay, so I have 10 years of experience almost. And 5 years relevance to this training part. And I was working as a shadow trainer for Savan Institute. And then only I just started my own. Okay. My native is different and I'm working, my working location is Chennai. Okay. So Savan Institute, I was working. After that only I just started my own there. And I completed Cloud Art certification 1 year, 2 year back. CCA 175 Spark, Azure Data Engineer Certification. And recently I completed Google Professional Data Engineer. This three I just completed. Right now I'm planning to do some certification in different platform also. It's going up. This is, I have certified and I have certification. Okay. And right now I'm working some IoT related platform with the video streaming analytics with the machine learning concept. It's in practice big data platform. From that exposure, I just include you for ML. Okay, just know about your trainer and a few other trainer available. They have some AWS certified. They will take some cloud service sessions. Okay.
Throughout the session,
what ML models are covered?
Which one?
What ML models are covered?
The ML model is not different, right? How that concept we'll be going to take it out. Any one of from supervised, any one of from unsupervised, it's a vary. Suppose we are in the project we are going to show you in two, one from Python, one from Spark ML library. So any one of them will be take from supervised and unsupervised. We will not be assured. Okay. Because so ML also separate member will be taking the session to you. So okay. Suppose they are going to take for supervised, unsupervised learning or supervised learning for Python. Another one we are going to cover via Spark. That's it. You must know how it is working.
Okay. So you're going to cover only two models.
Understanding how ML is working with big data platform. If suppose I have start ML, ML only will take more time. Almost 6 months of session is going on. Still it's not completed. So that we will not be go forward for ML.
Yeah, true. That's the reason I'm asking. Like,
yeah, just understanding how it is working. Such kind of kickstart will give you. Yep.
So the main concentration will be completely on the like Hadoop and Spark, right?
That's big data integrations. Yeah.
That is the main part, and you'll be the primary like trainer, right?
Yeah, I'm the responsible. I'm the owner for this all the training, okay. And other two trainer, one for machine learning related, another one trainer will be taking. For Spark ML, is supposed to, I will take it out, or that particular ML trainer itself, they will be taken.
Okay, only for the ML part, fine.
Yeah, ML and cloud is a different. That's it.
Cloud as well?
Cloud, Azure, and Databricks, I can take care. AWS, I'm not certified, so I request some certified trainer for that.
Okay.
So Azure, I know I can do that very confidently. As well as Databricks also I'm using. So that is also I know very well. Mm-hmm. AWS, I don't have certificate, but I know the concept. Anyhow, I will request to other members, to be honest. Okay. Anything else? For a few of them have some time zone issues. I will, once the session started, I will connect with our team members who are all joined our course, right? I will check with them. If supposed to change the timing, we can change it, no problem. But it should be in weekdays in the morning. Any half hour or 1 hour earlier, later, we can discuss after something. Okay, somebody's asking in chat, I just inform them. But we will not be assured. If everyone will be okay with this timing, we cannot change it. Yeah. Thank you. Any other question?
Hi, Dinesh.
Yeah, please.
By any chance, can you take this session as a 1 hour ahead?
Come again? I'm not understood.
By any chance, this session will be like a... can you take this session from 1 hour before or after that?
Yeah, that's, we will not be assured, because once the batch, private batch will be designed, right? That we can discuss. If everyone is okay, then we can change the timing also, no problem. Okay, because different time zone also, I know that few of them will be joined from US, few of them joined from Malaysia and some other places, UK. So I request everyone, we'll see that after the session start, then only we can. Okay, yeah, because everyone uses a global time, this is a common one, so that I just mentioned the time zone.
Exactly.
Because from the last batch also, I have seen some, daylight saving was changed. So based on that, we can change some time zone, timing. Okay, but exactly. Everyone should agree with that. That's very important. And daily 1 hour is not a big deal for you, but I consider your timing.
Actually, my timing is currently 3 a.m. in the morning, so I don't want to disturb others. So that's why I just want to be 1 hour before ahead.
Yes, I agree. I will check with the members. Yeah, I know that such kind of problem you will be faced. Not only you, few of them. We'll see. Overall, is nominated. Few of them is reserved. That's it, right? We'll check them. Right. At the time, if it is possible, we can change it.
Yeah. Fine. Thanks, man.
Yeah. Thank you. Any other question? No question? So hope you can understand, right? This one we are going to cover it. Python 3.6 version of Spark, we are going to use it. Python, PySpark, Spark 2x and 3x, both. Python more than 3.6. Yeah, this is approximate only I just mentioned. But it should trust more than that also. If everyone from tech platform, technical people will be joined this course, it will be close around 60. Yes, it depends on the people also, right? In the concept basis, we have planned to go. Any other question? ID, I informed how the assignments practice PM. Materials. Yeah, payment also few of them is asking, right? Payment, you can pay in twofold. by joining one first payment. After 1 month, you can pay the rest of them.
Dinesh, in terms of clarifications, right, how to approach?
That's a private batch. You have that WhatsApp group you have. You can raise it there or you can come to me one-to-one, no problem. Any doubts? Suppose while you are doing the hands-on, you may be stuck somewhere, you can raise in your private batch. Because it's a privacy, you may be stuck, you cannot raise it entirely into the other members. So in your team, you can raise it. You may be face the same issue for others also, right? So how he will be sort out that issue? That will help you. It's a kind of joining learning. That's it. Okay, separate batch.
So through only the WhatsApp? Only WhatsApp group?
Yeah, first is a private WhatsApp group. If suppose you are not convenience there, you can reach me in private also. Have my contact number, right? You can reach me. Okay? You may be stuck somewhere. You cannot get the answer properly. You can reach me. I am the responsible. Clear? Any other question?
Dinesh, one question. While working on the cloud, right?
Mm.
Are you going to explain the how hybrid setup will be done and also?
Sorry, what setup?
Hybrid setup. You know, sometimes we might have to operate with multiple clouds.
Multiple clouds is not hybrid way, but hybrid is different. How the warehouse will be interact with the cloud, such kind of hybrid is there. Here we are going to practice via some own cluster is there in Hadoop. EMR, SD inside, and that EC2 instance and bucket, S3 bucket, something is available, or data lake something. So how it is going to be interact with your environment? If suppose you're going to use S3 into EMR service, how it will be correlated, interacted? That is how you're going to face it, right? So same, we are going to do that here. Okay? Because easy to instance.
Go ahead, Dinesh. Sorry.
No, no, you just go ahead. Suppose I am not answer you, you can come.
Yeah, yeah. What I'm asking is, you see, I know there might be requirements where, you know, we might have the Azure, I mean, the EC2 instances are on the cloud. Sometimes we might able to, you know, access, might require to access the data from, you know, on-premises as well. How, you know, security is going to be set up. Is that something that you are going to be help us?
Security related, we will not be go in depth. Only that access keys creation, such kind of. While I'm doing the hands-on, you know, right? How I'm going to access by SSH key. So such kind of security, I can go in. We'll be going to discuss that. It's not an entirely cloud. How it is going to be interacted? So VPC connection, subnet creation, that all will not be covered here. Okay. Again, it's take more time.
Security
it's
out aspects, of order.
Security aspects, we will be go only for how the key we are going to create it. Suppose I'm going to use EC2 instance, how we can create the key. If suppose I'm going to access via as a, from local to cloud environment, we have to create some user keys, secret key and access key, such kind of things, right? Or I can create a manual user, I can give you that username details. So via that you can use it.
It's more going of to discuss FTP about, configuration kind of.
Yeah, such things is a roles and policy and user. In something is available, okay. Right? So how the role is reacted, how the user is reacting, how the policy is reacting there. So such kind of security will be covered. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, because if suppose you are going to take a security, security only will go more time. So how it will be, because in real time, you will go for the big data project, they will give you all the informations to you. You supposed to connect there, you want to do that access, right? So we will help you how that connections, we are going to use it in our code and get the data. We have a data from cloud environment, how we are going to connect that S3 bucket or blob or RDS via your local. That's we are going to see definitely. That I can show you. As well, how internally from S3 to EMR or EC2, how it is connected from virtual machine to blob storage or data like Gen1, Gen2, how we are going to connect them. Such kind of programming commands via, I can show you that things. That part I am surely will help you. Because that is you are going to do it in reality. Right? You are a developer, you are going to do some development code, you want to interact multiple services. So how you approach it? That you must know that the exposure, right? That I can help you via serverless architecture also. Lambda, using Lambda, how we can communicate the data. That always, as a data engineer, you must know such the basic things. That I will help you and you cover it. Even Lambda also, in AWS, we just plan to go via our Python. Okay, it's all about Python based development.
Okay.
Then only while you go for the interview, if suppose they will be asking any questions, you want to write the code, you will get confidence. How much you are doing the hands-on, that will help you. Okay.
Dinesh, while doing this Lambda exercise, also, are we also going to look at the CI/CD part of it?
Lambda will not come for the CI/CD, but if suppose you know, we can see the CI/CD. Lambda, we can use it for continuous integration or scheduling, batch processing, right?
Okay.
Because it's a data migration, serverless architectures, different CI/CD is different. How efficiently you're going to handle the data with low cost? That is the use of Lambda architecture, serverless architecture. Because always is not required for big data platform for your entire operations. Sometimes it will be expected for some serverless architecture for less costing. How we are going to do that?
Okay.
The course fee, you can refer the nomination I just mentioned you, G. You can select the option based on the option you have to pay. That's it. You can pay by 2. Already you know the nomination, right? You already filled the nomination, I think so. There, the course fee, everything is available. Where you select the course offered, there in the end, you can mention the prices. You can take it. That's what I'm saying. If the course you have started and in future, any tools will be raised here, any new tools will come. You already paid, you are my old student. Again, you don't want kickstart from the beginning. Any new technology comes, you want to pay certain amount for that particular technology. That's it. Just 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees maximum. You can pay and you can learn it. That's it. Because technology will not be going to end with this one, I'm sure. It will be keep on change. It will keep on upgrading. During that time, you don't want to pay entirely. For that example, I just inform you, Snowflake. Snowflake, if suppose you're going to take a separate session, it will be taking different charges for you. But we plan to include that in future. At the time, you can learn it, our environment itself. Just to pay for 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees for that particular, that's it. So you are, this is a kind of community creation, that's it. Okay, almost we have 18 members, 18 batch we have. Everyone will be in community. So we'll be discuss ourselves and we'll be sort of some issues. Or they will help you for references. Because community is most important, the my experience I'm saying. Definitely they will help you for your future upgrade. Okay, any other question? Almost 1 hour is going on. So suppose no question, we can close it today. And whoever is interested, you can chat me in private. We can go. Okay.
Tomorrow we have a session, right? Same time.
Sorry? Tomorrow also the same time.
Tomorrow
also, yeah. Tomorrow actual session. So today is a doubt clarification. Tomorrow will be an actual session discussion.
Okay.
Okay. Because you might have some doubts, you will not be get clarified, right? So that it's like an open topic. What we are going to cover it, what you are going to learn it. You must know that, right? That's it. Okay. So if you have those reserved your seats, you just come to me. If you are satisfied, you can confirm your availability. From tomorrow onwards, you can go forward with that. And whoever is interested, you can reach me in private. Difference between Docker, AWS is a kind of AWS data engineer. Are you supposed to select as a Azure data engineer that you can? Full stack will be covered all the point. That's it. Because few of them joined as a fresher, they don't know more exposure about the cloud at the time. So we will give you only the big data concept to them because he is a fresher. He doesn't want to learn as a full stack developer, but somebody will be experienced. So that they must know the full stack, how it will be. You suppose you are an architect, you need to learn everything. You are a cross platform, you must know everything. So that I just give you full stack. So you have idea how we are going to interact. Right? That is the difference between full stack and other. So what is your selection that you can opt in? It's not a forcing you. You want to take full stack, we never forcing you. It depends on your assumptions. Okay?
Dinesh, hello?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, thanks. Are you going to cover all the components in Hadoop or just you're just covering only Hive and MapReduce part?
No, as you mentioned earlier. This is the concepts. These are all only we will be covered it mainly. This one is a real time is they are using, right? MapReduce nobody is using MapReduce in the directory.
Yes.
Right? It's a waste, right? Even Scoop also they will not be used. So we just remove the Scoop again.
Okay.
Only fine. The trending who are using that things we just keep on upgrading.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. It's depends on experience for the salary for data engineer. If you have 10 years of experience, that salary range will be varied. And also based on the service company or production company, product based company. Based on the salary value will be varied. If suppose you are selecting into the product-based company, you have 5 years of experience, then you'll be reached more than 15 lakh minimum. If it is a service, you will be get more than 10 lakh. So there is some slight difference. That's it.
So how much experience can we project after the training?
It depends on your experience, total experience based on we can.
Okay, around something.
During
around
the certification and interview tips, I will tell you. As a panelist, I will help you. How they will expect from you.
Okay.
So do you have any Git link or something that I can see just to look at the kind of projects we are going to do?
No, we will not be upload there. We have some private places only we will be upload.
Will it be possible to quickly show just the project description, like for example in Spark, this is the...
No, it's some open project discussion also will be going on, right? This is a kind of project, okay? This is a kind of free project. The same we are going to upload via cloud, that's it. So few changes we have done, something, okay? There is some project we have loaded for that open trainer. Sorry, open learner, okay? This is little slightly changed based on the cloud and we can show you, that's it. Okay?
Okay.
Every 1 month, we plan to go for a workshop, but unfortunately, this month, we cannot do that properly. But whatever you learn, you can do the practice. That is very important. That only will help you. Interview questions with the answer also, we will give you, you can do the practice. Almost we have 500 questions we have. We will charge you. You can learn and do the practice.
So out of this 60-70 approximate hours, how much hours of dedicated practice would be required?
It depends on you, right? Depends on your interview, job selections. How you learn?
Not thinking from the job selection perspective, but being like grasping the knowledge from that.
From knowledge perspective, whenever we'll be taking the session, immediately you are doing the practice. So that is enough right now. Okay. Suppose you are going to do a different case studies, you can take it out of the case study and you can do the practice and come to me if you face any issues there. It will be vary. So it depends on your hands-on practice and knowledge exposure. We will going to show you some sample data with the JSON format or some ORC format. So while you are doing the practice, okay. But suppose you are going to take any other format of data, you may be stuck somewhere. Or that data will be corrupted. We will not be sure, right? So how you are going to approach it, how you are going to modify it. That will only keep on learning, you will be getting it. So just whatever you learn, you try to do that practice on the day itself. That is my opinion.
And in this whole process, are we touching base on any of the data warehousing services?
Data warehousing services, we will not be using directly. Only for cluster analysis we are doing. That's part in the future, we plan to go with Snowflake or data warehousing. Because with data warehousing also must be required. So that we just plan and it will be in our list.
So is it going to be in the next batch?
I'm not sure. I just request the people. So some case studies is going on. Because if we are going to use all the paid service, then the charges will be vary, right? So it will be common and it should be satisfied for the joining members. So everything we have to consider it.
Right, Snowflake is initially free for 30 days, correct?
That's not enough, right? Supposed to start So that everything we have to consider it. We have to, we have free tires, we have used that and it's expired. While we are going further in practice, we must open it and we need to detail explain it. It will be in charges.
Are you also planning to include DBT in future?
We have few things in our list, it will not be confirmed still. This is finalized right now. I have to check with other trainer if any new training technology we have to include, then we can consider and we can include it. That's it.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, because training technology will be varying. So how the job requirement is there, everything we have to focus based on the problem, we can select the particular training technology. Am I right?
All right. So just to clarify, you mentioned in future, if you add more technologies, then we'll have to pay more, something extra to see that recordings, right?
Sorry, come again. I'm not understanding.
My question is right now, if I enroll and complete this course, but in future, if you add Snowflake or some new technology, if I have to go through that, I have to pay something extra, right? To see that.
Yeah, certain, just maximum 1,000 or 2,000. It will not cross more than that. Only what we are going to do, that existing batching is going on. At the time when the Snowflake is started, I can include you. It's not a Snowflake, any other new technology also. Understanding I'm saying. So you can pay and you can learn it. That's it. You will keep on upgrading yourself with the limited charges. That's it. Sure. You can raise your doubts, you can raise your queries, we will help you, we will sort out the issues. Okay, right. It's a kind of keep on touching with us, that's it. Whenever you will be upgraded, definitely we will upgrade you, that's it.
Sure. Thanks, Dinesh, for answering.
Yeah. Okay, guys. I think today is enough. We have discussed a lot of things. Any question you can raise me, or we can close it today. Any question? Come to me in private chat also, no problem. Okay, no question. Okay, guys, tomorrow we can connect at the same time. We can go forward.
Yeah, thanks, Dinesh, for your session.
Yeah, thank you all.
Thank you.